Right, so this is the walkthrough for Mystery Business by Paramore from the Grade 3 Trinity Rock and Pop Bass Books from 2018. Right, so the whole piece is played with a pick as mandated at the top. So again, Dunlop stubbies are a good way to go. So your introduction is played pan muted, so just using the flashy bit of your hand to mute wherever you feel most comfortable. I find on this bass down the bottom give you the best kind of sound. So all you're doing for your intro is going back and forth between the D and the G. So I would use your first finger to play the lower note and your third finger to play the upper note. So you've got... You then come into these accented sevenths, which where your middle finger just comes across nicely. Then you're repeating that initial phrase and then coming down the D from the ninth fret. A good chunk of the rest of the piece is just that main riff that everyone knows. So you're starting on the fourth fret of the E, coming up to the fourth fret of the A, to the sixth fret, then coming down to the second fret on the E the first time. You then repeat the 4-4-6 pattern, and then you come down to an open string. You repeat that whole thing, and then you're coming down to a quaver pattern, 7-6 descending on the E string. So. Oh my god. Then repeats for your verse, your chorus, slightly different. So you're basically doing a walking bass pattern up the A and the E, E and the A. So. So start on the open string on the E. So that's your first two lines, coming down to the third and fourth lines, you've got some staccato quavers interspersed with little riffs. So. So your little riffs there, your first one is a 0-2-0 from the E to the A. Second one, you're coming up from the second fret to the fourth fret on the E. I would downstrum these because you get a better accent. You're then coming up the octave to the E on the second fret of the D string. For your sweep down here, I would use a pick strum pattern of up, down, up, down, because it means you can sort of glide over that A. Then into the last one. For your breakdown, you are starting with a 7th fret on the A, sliding up to a 14, back down to a 9, and then a 6-8 on the D string. So. You then come into this ascending pattern on the A and the D strings. So you're just going back and forth, but it's quite fast. So the trick here is the speed. So I'd use your bottom finger to play the first note, third finger to play the upper note. So the first two, you've got the 7-9 on the AD. You're then going to come up. So sliding from the 7 up to the 9th, from the D to the A to the D. And then playing the 9th on the D, 11th on the G. fourth fret and bar the fourth, and you're going to get the four into the 4-6-4-6. You're then sliding that up from the 4 to 6-8, and then across to the 6-9. The only change I would make is probably bring in your pinky across to play that ninth fret there. So. And that leaves you set up for the next pattern. So. So your instrumental, again, you're going back to a walking bass kind of pattern. And the rest is just quavered eighths, so. Yeah, that's pretty much it.